What's up, ladies and gents? Hey, listen, are you looking for a MetaTrader 4 tutorial? That's for beginners for iPhone? If so, you are in the right place. For more Forex and cryptocurrency videos, guys, go ahead and subscribe to my channel and also click the bell notification above to be notified when I drop new content every week. All right, what is going on, ladies and gents? This is Eddie Harvey coming to you from my home here in Chicago, Illinois. Hey, listen, what I want to do today, I want to talk to you guys about giving you guys a MetaTrader 4 breakdown, a walkthrough. If you're on iPhone, I want to share with you what the inside of it looks like and what you can get access to and how to just go ahead and navigate it. So let's get right into it. All right, ladies and gents. So listen, what we're going to do, we're going to talk about, I'm going to give you a quick MetaTrader 4 tutorial for beginners who are using it on their iPhone. So if you look here on my screen in the corner here, left-hand corner, you're going to see MetaTrader 4, right? So let's tap that. Now, what we're going to do here, guys, is that we're going to go over here. As you can see, it has already, that's a Hugo's Way demo account I have selected. But when you first get to MetaTrader 4, you're going to have a bevy of options here. So when you log in, you're going to see new account, mailbox, news, trade days. You don't have to worry about any of that. Any of this other stuff, I don't focus on any of it. The first thing you want to look for is new account. So if you come to new account, it's going to give you a couple of options. Okay. You're going to have open a demo account or log into an existing account. Okay. So, or excuse me. Obviously to open a real account, please contact your broker. So they're telling you that because you can open a MetaTrader 4 demo account as well. So if I went to open a demo account, as you can see, there's a MetaTrader 4 demo account. There's a Hugo's Way demo account. Now, if you had another broker, whatever broker you wanted to select, you would click under here on the servers. And then all you're going to do is use search and find your broker. So let's say if you had a brokerage account with FX Choice, I'm just naming some brokers. All you're going to do is type in FX Choice, right? Excuse me, then it'll show right here, classic demo and pro demo. So whatever broker you have an account with, right? If it was Hugo's Way demo, okay? Whatever broker, just type in the first letter, A, B, whoever it is. All you have to do is simply just start typing in whatever the beginning alphabet is for that name and it'll come up, simple as that. All right, so let's go back out of here. Now, if you want to log into an existing account, as you can see here, log into an existing account, use your login to connect, login password to connect to the broker of your choice. Now, when you come in here, if you have already set up a brokerage account, as you can see, a few of my accounts here, you got Hugo's Way Real, you got Hugo's Way Demo, I got KLT Live. So whoever you have, once again, the same thing, is going to allow you to just start typing in and looking for a real account. So if you had Trader's Way, okay? Trader's Way Demo, Trader's Way Live. And all you would do is that you will select your live account, your demo account, whatever, and you would then, it's going to ask you for a username and password. Let's say if I wanted to do Trader's Way, okay? Let me go back to that. And let's say I want to do a live account. Now it's going to ask me for my login that I set up with Trader's Way, which is going to be your your MetaTrader 4 login number, your account login number, should I say, excuse me, and the password you set up, which you should receive in your email. So whatever your email address is, just go type in whatever, if it's Trader's Way account, and then it'll pop up with your username and password. And then you would just enter that in and then you'll be onto the database. So we're going to go back here. Once you're onto the database, as you can see here, it'll show you different accounts. So as you can see here, I have multiple accounts. It'll show you real, live, demo. For whatever broker, it'll say real, it'll say demo. I got a few accounts in here because I separate my accounts by Forex, by crypto, by indices. So I got everything kind of sectioned out, okay, to what I'm trading, my account that I'm compounding, the account that I'm utilizing to pull from weekly. So a lot of different things you see here. But as you can see, I really like Hugo's way, as you can tell from this. And by no means from watching this video am I telling you to get Hugo's way. You're free to get whoever you want to get, okay? All right, so let's go back over here. Now, once you have your demo set up, once you're logged in, so if I want to log in, to go to my demo I have selected here, look at the bottom, you're gonna see quotes. Remove this. You'll see quotes, chart, trade, history, and settings, okay? What you wanna go to is click the trade button. Now, when you click trade, it'll show you once you set up your demo account, whoever your broker was, when you set up your demo account, it'll show your balance, it'll show the equity, margin, free margin, all that stuff, right? And margin level percentage. So now, from here, you will go over again to quotes. Excuse me, not quotes, you're gonna go to chart. Not chart, I'm losing myself. Quotes, yes, you're gonna go to quotes. Okay, when you go to quotes, as you can see, it'll show all of the brokers. It'll show all of the brokers, right, that you have right here. And it'll typically have the main eight. The main eight are AUD, USD, Euro, USD, GBP, USD, NZD, USD, UCAD, UCHF, UJ, and those are the main ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, and then these are a couple more I got added right here, okay? So if you want to add more pairs, more currency pairs, you just hit the plus sign in the top right-hand corner. So when I click on that, I can come in here, and now, as you can see, I can add exotics, indices, futures, stocks, FX crosses, energies, metals, cryptos. So one of the reasons I like Hugo's way, just telling you why, is because I can trade, again, Forex, I can trade indices, I can trade futures, oils, metals, cryptos, I can trade it all. So that's why I like utilizing them. So if I wanted to add some more FX crosses, I would come here, and now this is where I can add all of the main FX cross pairs, okay? Simple as that. So it's pretty simple, guys. Not hard to use at all. Hey guys, listen. I know this video is a little long, but you're halfway there. Stay with me, all right? With the halfway point, take a break, relax, get you a cup of coffee, whatever you need to do, but you're almost there. All right, keep watching. And that pretty much, that's all to it. If you want to check, you got down your history. So if, let's say if a trade closed out, you would go select history. And when you select history, it'll show nothing today, it'll show the week or whatever. So a couple of trades I took on this new demo account, and it shows right there, you know, what it shows, then it'll show for the month, okay? All of that, you can customize it to show, and right up here, you see all of that, you can customize it to show whatever the days and the weeks you want to show, okay? Now, if you want to go to the charts, you go back over here to charts, and this is where the charts is at, okay? When you go to charts, if you look here, if you're saying, well, where, how do I add indicators, anything like that? The first thing you want to hit, you want to go to the top of the screen, and you want to hit the FX button, okay? Hit the little F button right here in the middle. You hit that, you come here, you got your main window. It's telling you what to do. To add an indicator, tap window title. Once you tap window title, you come in here, here's where all your indicators are at. Trends, right? Oscillators, you got everything right in there. There go your MACD, you know, moving average of oscillator, RSI, all of that is in here, okay? Fibonacci, everything is in here, okay? So you can add it all from right here, all right? So when you go back out, let's say if I wanted to add moving averages, okay? Now when I go in here, it's showing you how to do it. You can select a period. If I want to do a 50 moving average, I could. You could select method, change it to simple or exponential, however I want to do it. Open or close, I can do that. Everything, if I want to change the colors, I could. So if I want to keep this blue, and if I want to add a level, I could. If I want to keep this blue, where I can change the color, you can do it all right here. I'll leave the blue just to show you what it looks like. Now there's the 50 moving average line right there. That's how it would look, okay? Now as you can see, I got a black grid. If I wanted to change my main grid, I'll show you how to do that in a second. First, let's go talk about the plus button here. So when you hit the plus button here, all it's doing is taking, as you can see, it brings up like the little radius line that you can move around. See that? The vertical and horizontal line box if you want to track something. So if you don't want that on, just hit that plus and it'll take it off. Now, if you go over here, this is where I can delete objects. All of that, if I want to delete all of this these different things, I could, okay? Or if I wanted to add an object, I could. So if I wanted to add, let's say this is, I just added Fibonacci, I just hit that from there. There's Fibonacci added in right there, right? If I want to delete it, I just hold on it, delete it, boom. Okay? So once you play around with it, you'll see how simple it is to use it. If I press down on the screen, it'll take all of the grid lines away. I put it back, it'll bring them up. If I press down on the, tap the screen again, as you can see here, I got trade, I got indicators, objects, and settings. Now, if I go to settings, this is where I can go change my colors at. I can change from a bar chart to a line chart, to candlesticks. If I want a bar chart, I'll do that. You can see, I'll go back, now I got bar charts, okay? So, clicked off the wrong thing. Get that off of there. Where am I at? Wrong thing. Bring my screen back. Where we go? Oh, there it is. Okay. Back to what we were doing. Sorry, man. I got all type of things going in here. There we go. Getting back to where I was at. So, coming back in here. from here, if I tap back on the screen again, I go to settings. If I want to change the colors, I can do it all from there. I can take off the ask price line, period separators, trade levels. You can take off all of these different things, okay? So if I want to change the colors, I can come in here. I can make my custom screen. I can go custom, or I can go black on white, green on black. So if I want to go green on black, I do that. Now you're going to see that my screen is different. There you go, green on black, okay? I want to go back to the basic black on white screen. It's the same thing. Boom. Now it's going to be a white screen with black. There you go. So as you can see, I prefer the darker screen. You can change the color of your candles, all these different things, play around with it. And it's real simple, guys. You just got to get in here for the most part with MT4, play around with the settings. And I know this is for iPhone, but it's very similar, I believe, I threw my settings off. It's very similar on Android as well. So, I got to get that back. So I didn't throw my settings off, guys, but it's all good. I'll get them back to what I had them at. But, I just wanted to share this with you guys. I'll worry about that later. I hope you all receive some value from this. So, obviously, can't really see too much of none of that. That's really bright and ugly. So let's get up off of that. So guys, there you have it. That's pretty much a breakdown of MetaTrader. That's what it's on the inside. That's what it looks like. Play around with the app is great. Just keep getting your settings right. You can, until you get comfortable. That's the biggest thing. I like my dark screen with my red and green candles. That's what works best for me. And once again, you can add any and everything from inside of it. So if I went a little fast, I know I made this video a little longer, but just go back and rewatch it and you'll be able to see all of the things that you can do inside of MetaTrader 4, especially if you're utilizing it from your phone, guys. This is going to be your main hub for trading, right? So you want to get familiar with what you have access to, all right? So there you have it, guys. Listen, I hope you received some value from that. I truly appreciate you guys checking it out. I went a little longer than I wanted to, but I definitely wanted to drop value for you guys. Listen, if you want to learn more about Forex trading, if you're looking to learn how to trade Forex in or crypto, guys, be sure to check out the link below in the comment section or simply go to tradewithed.com to find out more about the platform that I utilize. Also, guys, I have a free community over on Facebook. Feel free to join that, guys, where I give an inside look, tips, techniques, results from the products that's inside of our platform as well. So be sure to hop over on Facebook and join me in my community over there. Once again, ladies and gents, I truly appreciate you all hopping on. Again, I hope you received value, guys. And if you did, if you found this video to be of value to you, do me a huge favor and go ahead and hit that like button. And also be sure to go ahead and subscribe to my channel. And then definitely click the bell notification to be notified when I come with more videos for you guys weekly. Once again, thank you. I appreciate you and I'll talk to you all later. Take care. What is up, ladies and gents? Hey, did you enjoy that video? If you did and you want to check out more of my content, go ahead. I got two videos right here for you to check out related to the topic that we just discussed. And listen, if you want to see more of my content, be sure to subscribe to my channel and also hit that bell notification to be notified when I drop new content. Also, don't forget to like.